Hi, it's Phil Eastwood here. Welcome to the 19th edition of our Living Leadership Weekly Message, focused on things that you can do right now to help grow your influence and impact on those around you. But it's especially about growing yourself. We publish each Living Leadership episode in a variety of ways and on a variety of platforms, enabling you to either read, watch, or listen to it. Each episode is no more than a few minutes long, making it easy and simple for you to digest, action, and share with those that you feel may benefit from its content. Before I get going this week, I wanted to ask for your help. We have set up a link to a very quick survey in this week's Living Leadership blog post, and I'm asking you to spend a couple of minutes answering just 5 questions on the format and content of our weekly messaging. Our goal is always to be of value and service to you, and this will be a way of you telling us whether we're doing that. I would really appreciate you taking the time to share your thoughts. Thank you. Here is this week's personal development piece. In a previous blog post, I focused on the importance of self-awareness as a highly beneficial aspect of having a balanced and fulfilling interior life. With this second installment on self-awareness, I'd like to focus more on how it can positively impact leaders and their leadership style. To recap, the first part of this blog post looked at how self-awareness was a key component of one's emotional intelligence. It broadly defined self-awareness as being in tune with one's own personality and individuality, which can be thought of as a foundation to how we view ourselves and our emotions in different predicaments and different day-to-day interactions, or in just being. Being self-aware is not only an ability to see yourself as the person that you truly are, it is also about allowing yourself to be guided by that knowledge in your daily interactions with other people. It serves an equally important function by creating dissonance during those moments when you are not behaving as your true self. Hopefully, such dissonance inspires you to seek a way to bridge that gap. It goes without saying that self-awareness is a fundamentally important aspect of one's psychological maintenance, development, and perspective. Self-awareness also has a really close relationship with emotional intelligence, which is a real key to successful leadership. Many different factors make a great leader, and a heightened level of self-awareness is definitely one of them. Most, if not all, successful leaders have to some extent honed their ability to recognize themselves as individuals who can be separated from the environment that they are in, the individuals around them, or any predicament that they find themselves as a part of. But it's definitely much easier said than done. It starts with leaders looking at themselves through different lenses and being open to seeing the good, the bad, and the ugly. In other words, recognizing the multiple perspectives that form the full and completely honest picture of their leadership style. Through this process, and it takes time, leaders can start to improve their ability to self-reflect. That said, self-reflection is only as good and beneficial as the objective behind it. A leader must take this on with a real sense of purpose in mind, which means adopting a strategy with clear objectives for the leader and for her or his organization. It's also important to note that self-reflection is a multifaceted process. It involves not only looking backward, but should also have leaders being proactive by looking ahead as well. There are some effective tools at a leader's disposal to do this. Some leaders meditate and practice mindfulness, which is highly recommended in developing one's emotional intelligence and level of self-awareness. Other leaders may prefer writing down their thoughts as a way of looking back and reflecting on different issues or challenges. Many leaders also turn to executive coaching for additional support and guidance. A challenge when leaders attempt to perform a thorough assessment of their leadership style is what might be regarded as a gap between how they see themselves versus how they are seen by others. And one effective approach to resolving this challenge is through the help of executive coaching. Coaches compose important questions, challenging questions, that provide additional tools that can facilitate that process of self-discovery. For instance, by providing an opportunity to work one-on-one and to challenge maybe long-held assumptions, a coach can assist in the process of reframing problems and provide really valuable feedback that can elevate the process of self-reflection to a perhaps unexpected level. By working with a leader to identify negative traits, coaches can also help direct the process through collaborative approaches that can help to alter mindsets. For example, might there be an approach a leader has not taken in the past but wishes they could in the future? And if so, how can that positively be integrated into a leadership style that serves the greater good of all who are involved? The only way leaders can truly evolve and excel in their role is to continually evaluate and reflect on their performance, decisions, and interactions. And all of this will lead to an honest account of what the strengths are and weaknesses are for that leader. And from there, the compass is given to them and a map for growth. What am I reading this week? It is 18 Minutes by Peter Bregman. Based on his popular Harvard Business Review columns, Peter Bregman's new guide gently shows how busy people can cut through all of the daily clutter and distractions and finally find a way to focus on those key items that are truly the top priorities in our lives. Bregman works on the premise that the best way to combat constant and distracting interruptions is actually to create productive distractions of one's own. Shared in a series of real bite-sized chapters, his approach allows us to efficiently navigate through the constant chatter of emails, text messages, phone calls, and endless meetings so that we can focus our time and energy on what we can truly care about. Mixing first-person insights with compelling case studies, Bregman sprinkles this captivating book with pathways that help guide us and pathways that get us on the right trail in 18 minutes or less. It's a good read. What is this week's smile? Well, this week I wanted to show you a brilliant short animated movie about how lucky we are to have guide dogs in our lives. It is called Pip and is definitely worth 4 minutes of your time. But it's also a heartwarming tale for underdogs everywhere, as Pip is the story of a small dog with a big dream. Punch in Pip, a short animated film, to your search engine and smile at what over 193 million other people have smiled at. What's my call to action for you this week? Well, let's go back to developing self-awareness. Perhaps you are not ready yet to enlist the services of a coach, so let's select another option, the one where you write down your thoughts as a way of looking back and reflecting on different issues or challenges. Winston Churchill said, "The farther backward you can look, the farther forward you can see." So, grab a journal and start doing what I have been doing for over 20 years. Well, I hope you enjoyed this week's Living Leadership. Stay tuned for another message next week. And in the meantime, please stay healthy and safe. And do that survey. Thank you.